Hello. How is everybody doing today? So we are a little bit later than we wanted to be this week. I wanted to start yesterday streaming, but unfortunately it didn't happen. And today's only going to be about 3.5 hours, so it's okay. We'll live with it. It looks like my VS Code wants me to update it. I'm just going to go ahead and do that. They have like updates like all the time. It's kind of like I don't have any issues with the software as it is. I almost think like I'd rather not do the updates, but it's annoying to have the pop up. We'll go ahead and do it at early in the stream, might as well. So go ahead and check out what we have completed thus far on the front end. This is my current website, and we're doing mobile friendly design, and previously the website was not friendly on mobile. So on our homepage, for example, it breaks. So looking at our new website, this is no longer the case. We have implemented Bootstrap and media queries and all that sort of stuff. And we're getting a nice, it still doesn't, still not like the most beautiful thing in the world, but it does work. You can now have a reasonably good experience on mobile, on my website. So we'll go and take a look around the website. So our user portal is complete and mobile friendly. Our premium promotional page is done and mobile friendly. Our project navigation page is complete and mobile friendly. And our educational page is complete and mobile friendly. So we've also gotten into the content of the website. We've designed a mobile friendly look at our materials pages. And this is the most recent work we've done. So continuing on the website means we're gonna have to get into the project pages, which there's, let's see. We'll take a look at the current website. On the project, we changed up the navigation quite a bit, if you can tell. On this page, go to the workout bar. And actually, I gotta be right back. I have some food in the stove, and I think I forgot about it. But one second. Okay, yeah, my bad. I accidentally left my, not, it wasn't even a mistake. Like I did accidentally leave my stuff on the stove, like without thinking about it for probably too long. But I bought this rice that simply like doesn't cook, and it's still like barely even cooked. Like it's just now, like it's like on the edge of like being like undercooked, like kind of difficult to eat. And it worked, it's good. I'm happy with it. This will be the best cooked rice I've had recently. So this is my projects page. This is a bunch of different pages underneath the projects category. So we need to basically style up all these pages. And in order to view them so we can see how they're designed, oh, I need to make this page too. Forgot about that. And this isn't... I collect like this information later. I don't know why. We'll go to projects. And the step-by-step page. So we're just going to be designing... all steps. I want to think about this navigation as well. Yeah, I'm not sure what I want to do with this, if I'm going to redesign it. I think that there are issues with the usability of this page and also the look of it. Like, certainly on mobile, you don't want this space. Like, that's not going to fly with me. But additionally, like, maybe this could be improved. I need to do a better job, like, with my whole entire presentation. I really, really, really need to, like, show the final product. Like, I don't even do that. Okay. So parts list page. I like this. It just needs to be made mobile friendly. And to what level is it already? It's absolutely not mobile friendly. probably just some Flexbox or Bootstrap implementation will fix it. But obviously, yeah, I mean, this is really just a matter of Bootstrap implementation. So this might be the large sized, and we're gonna break it a 3 at, you know, maybe medium. We're gonna break it to 3 at large, and then we're gonna break it to maybe 2 at medium, and then maybe 1 at extra, one at small. Like, that might be how it goes. So it'll be pretty easy to fix this page, make it nice, and then economy. Also not gonna be an issue. I'm wondering how I want to do it on mobile. Maybe on mobile I give these things like cards. I make it like five sheets of paper is a little bit of a separated card, because like this list, if we can look here, it'd be really tough to like get in here and tap all of these check boxes, I think. I think they're a little bit too close to each other. So, we've got a total of four different designs to do. Which is they're pretty straightforward. They're just, and then this implementation of this navigation is going to be, and the way I do this is kind of fun too. I include PHP files into this. So, or I include HTML. So based on what I'm looking at, and this is only for the video. So these are individual pages. And that means I have this navigation located on every single page. Okay. I guess our first job is to implement this video page, or at least like, We gotta set up our hierarchy here. So we're going to be, let's think about this. How do we have it currently? So let's go to, like, so on the old website, this was in projects/tripod/video.php. That's pretty much exactly how I want it to be. So if I go to projects, so this is /projects. So I'm going to have to create a new folder called projects. And then I'm going to have to oh, and this is actually like I'm going to have like a promos folder and like a I'll have a promos folder in my hosting, and then I'll also have a video and a projects folder. Yeah. For project/promos. Wow. Markup. Let me work this out. How do I want to run this? So in projects, tripod workout bar. So, okay, that's how I wanted to do it. I said so I'm gonna have a page. A page like workoutbar.php, that's going to be my promotional. It's going to be like the details of the workout bar. And then you get in here, and that's where we're going to have different bits of information that we add on the project. So how to video, step-by-step economy, or video how to economy and parts list. So parts.php. Having some pretty rockety internet connection, it looks like, on my OS or my OBS. Let me know if the stream is lagging at all. I'm not watching the stream currently, so I'm not sure. Okay. So that's that might be how it works. So I've got open up this. Gonna get a lot of stuff close. And close this. I need that open. Keep opening up these things. Oh my god. Okay, so tripod. Okay, so this is how we're gonna run it. Instead of going slash promos, we're gonna go slot projects slash tripod. Okay. This is interesting because previously I did all of my URLs with a .htaccess, but I think the way that that works, you are limiting yourself to not being able to like change, like if I have a folder named projects and I want to navigate to this tripod page, the URL is automatically going to be project/tripod.php. So I change tripod.php, I say in the htaccess to make the URL project/tripod, removing the .php. Now there's an error because if I try to access projects.php, you can't have a folder name and a URL and like a file name that are the same and the same. So I need to figure out a different way of doing my URL changes, which is something I should have gotten to anyways, but we're gonna have to, like right now it's fine because I have a folder name of tripod, or I have a folder name of projects, but I have a file named projects.php. I think that that's okay. Like I think I can get into educational. I have an educational.php and an educational. I can view educational.php and then I can go into the educational folder. Okay, so we're going to actually recreate this page for our view details link. View details is going to bring us, God, I'm like, view details is going to bring us to this page. Like this is, the way I do this now is just gross, I think. Like a lot of my pages have a .htaccess written for them, but a lot of them don't. Like the way I wanna, I had to do materials education slash materials index off of like a zero. Like this is, but not even in a subfolder. And then I go to materials education, and I have to skip this level. Like I want this to, yeah. So this is what we're fixing. This is what we're fixing. I think on an SEO level, this will make more sense to the computer. So that's good. Let me bump up the zoom on here so the other people can read this. I don't need to do this right now. Run your index PHP. All files it cannot normally find on your website. I want to do it with PHP. Whoa, hello Robin. Oh wow! Dude, great stream earlier. I really, really, really fun watching you, man. I think JavaScript is one of my weaker points. I'm not an incredibly strong developer, is it? I don't have, you know, formal education, like I said. So I try to do my best with learning from, you know, any number of sources that I can. And, you know, it's great to see like someone who knows and is in industry as well. So I appreciate your stream for sure. Thank you for the follow too. great stuff. Okay, so put the following in your htaccess. So okay, it runs your index.php. All files it cannot normally find in your site. Okay, so it trims the leading slashes on the URL or URI. I don't 100% know the difference. I guess I don't know the difference at all. I don't know what the difference between URI and a URL. And then you're going to, is that, I forget, does that create an array? Does explode create an array? Or do you just remove flashes? I don't think that's true. It creates an array. If there's no elements in the array, or if there's no element in the first part of the array, you're gonna show a homepage, which show homepage is probably some function to load the homepage. Else switch array shift element. I'm not sure what array shift does. Sure, Ellen. Passes rest of parameters to kernel. He's not like showing his function. These are caps. These might not even be personally defined functions, right? I'm not familiar with this PHP. I really love PHP documentation. I think it's great. He's defined. Okay. I don't know these internal functions. We're gonna figure this out once we get there. For now, let's go ahead and figure out these pages. I'm gonna take a look. Timing the right thing? Oh no! This is the most frustrating thing ever. I made this thing, it's called a lifetimer. And it's a great little program, and it helps me time my activities during the day. So like I woke up, I did a little bit of reading on the computer, I had breakfast, then I played Dota, and then I ate lunch, which I call a snack. But it's the most frustrating thing when I start to do something and then I forget to record it. So now I have like an inaccurate data entry of the fact that I'm coding my website. So that's unfortunate. And this is I love this programming language. It's called Mathematica. And I mean, this is essentially their IDE. Math is Mathematica. It's a good programming language. It's very high level. A lot of functions that do a lot of stuff that are already pre-built. James, hey, how are you doing, man? You want to record stuff like that, you should look at Toggle. I think I may have heard of Toggle. I have heard of this. I don't like their app. And I've coded my own and I like what it does. I even have like a start at a at like an analysis page. So viewlife.nb. I can't run it on everything, but I sit at home all day anyways. So that's okay. I can't run this on anything other than desktop, and a desktop that has Mathematica. So that's certainly an issue. Although I am able to download Mathematica Cloud, which allows you to cloud deploy Mathematica, which is cool, but it's so slow, especially this program. And I don't know if it's because of the way that I'm doing it or if it's because of just Mathematica Cloud, but so we've done everything. So I can look at all the little pie charts that I've created of my past days, and I can look at how things are changing. And then I also have these graphs, which show every single like a line chart of all of my days. So like. Like I sometimes I think that this right here is an example of where I forgot to stop my timer. So now it looks like I've eaten for like 4 hours straight this day. And then, so I can look at this, and I guess some days I don't eat at all. Sometimes I exercise for like hours, other times I don't. And then this is like me taking my dog outside. Probably consistently around that level. Program Mathematica for that much. It's hard to program Mathematica and time things in Mathematica. This is my Dota. This is pretty insane. It's kind of growing, it looks like. This is how much time I spend learning, and as you can see, I learn less and less in Dota, and I lose more and more. That's me, like, I think this was like an error. I didn't mean to have a food category. Cooking, Twitch. This is me watching Twitch, this is me watching live streams. I watch a lot of YouTube, not as much as I do like Dota, but I spend a good amount of time on YouTube. Yeah, it was RuneScape stuff. Do you play RuneScape? I used to like I would say I still really like the game, but yeah, look at it. I have a RuneScape category. I was excited, like this idea came about because I wanted a way to record how fast I was doing things in RuneScape and seeing if I was improving. I was my goal when I made this. I wanted to see how much faster I was doing like farm and herb runs on RuneScape. Dude, it's a great game. I play Dota almost exclusively now, but RuneScape was my main game for probably 12 years, and I still, yeah, exactly, an herb run. But yeah, it's been a long time I played it. I'm sure I'm gonna go back to it eventually and play, but for right now, I'm pretty much exclusively playing Dota because I appreciate how competitive it is, and there's so much to learn, and it ends up being exciting all the way through. It's like RuneScape might be fun if I eventually built an account that was freaking awesome at PKing, but then there's always like I'm a PKer, and I just don't think that PKing has enough room for improvement. And so now that I'm finding something where constantly you can find new skills and new little improvements for yourself, that it's become addicting, really. And then so I will go continue. These are like I have like these small categories, and there's a lot of detail here, but this is these are broader categories, like eating. This is cooking, eating, anything. Animating, animation. Haven't gotten to animate a lot recently, but a lot of these days, like 6-hour sessions of doing animation. Exercising. Probably need to work on this a little, but my dog going outside and going on walks and stuff like that. And Dota, yeah, climbing. All forms of Dota. This is my girlfriend's business. Occasionally, we'll work on that. Shopping. Relax is like watching YouTube, watching Twitch. Do-it-yourself resource, my personal business. Some days I spend a lot. Like this is over probably 2 months. So you can see like there's not a whole lot of data in here, 23 samples. So I work on it a lot. Sometimes I work on it not a whole lot other times. Yeah, I'd say my other half is programming right now. I really do like it. My favorite thing to do is probably animate. I really want to be better at animation. But yeah, this is my large, this is everything combined. Like this is how I spend my time. I spent over a quarter of my life playing Dota, and I spend another 20%, doing things for my business. So yeah, it's interesting for sure. And then, yeah. It's like, realistically, like this is how I would, unless I was all of a sudden, like making money with Dota, like obviously, like everyone wants to do the thing that they love, you know, all day. It's just not possible with something like video games. Like I would feel really good about myself if instead of Relax and Dota, that was all do-it-yourself resource. That would be great, but I don't know. It's hard. But that's why I create something like this, so I can see what I'm doing versus what I actually think. I'm doing. I would expect that do-it-yourself resource is higher. I convinced myself that it is, but yeah. Yeah, we'll keep those things open. We'll get to that URL rewriting eventually. the details page, should it have a navigation? Should it have this? I don't think it should. Yeah, HTAccess is easy, but I don't know how to do it in PHP yet, and I know it's fairly simple. I know how to grab the, on my website I have grabbed a URL before, and I do different, I have like the code where I grab the URL, but I don't know how to manipulate it. Which is, it's just a matter of doing research. I'm trying to focus on front end though, because I'm just trying to get myself mobile implemented, and then I'll work on all the sort of like actual implementation later. You know, getting it online and ready and functional. So we're going to recreate this page. WD, hi, how are you doing? What's going on? I'm eating rice, so I'm sorry about that. Okay, let's just do this. Let's just do it. Let's take a look at, for example, educational.php. You think so? Oh my gosh. That's a compliment right there. I appreciate that. I don't really have a lot of experience in design, but I made sure that I at least got like the colors matching and things like that. And it's amazing how far that goes. I mean, there's probably a lot that like doesn't look quite right, but It's been a journey. I've been working on this for a long time, and it's quite the project. And I'm hoping that making it mobile friendly will enable the growth of this website more than if it didn't have that. So we're implementing the mobile platform now, and I already have the actual website out there and published. But what we're gonna do now is, yeah, get it mobile friendly so that we are ready to take the audience that we might have eventually. Especially for something, I'm publishing do-it-yourself projects on this website. So if I want my user base to be able to have a very easy way to follow these projects, then they need a way to view things mobile friendly. Otherwise, they'd have to print out a bunch of HTML pages. So if they can go into their garage or whatever and they can look at the website and go through like step-by-step the projects, that's going to be a much better experience for them than, you know, the potential of like not really being able to work on their stuff while they have the website open. So yeah, we got all of our little includes here that we need. And this is a footer level 1, level 2. Footer level 2.php. Okay. So we're going to start out with, this is gonna be a section. Section class equals all I think that's simple. And then we're gonna have two sections of the page, which are going to not move as the page gets larger. So that's gonna be These two. So maybe they should even be rows. No. We do, yeah. We'll do a row inside. We'll embed rows. So in this one, we just put a video in there. And this guy. And in this guy, we're going to put a row, and we're going to put a call xs-12. We're going to put two call-xs-6. Or they're not going to be xs-. They're going to be xs-12, but they're going to be maybe medium or large-6. Class equals. So let's get. Whoa, Patty, how are you doing, man? How have the streams been recently? Are you still working on what the heck were you playing? Your some assassin game. It was something with like time warping and like I'm not up to. I should know this. Like I do know it. It was Dishonored. Yes, you're playing Dishonored. Have you finished Dishonored? Yeah, I don't really like Bootstrap is fairly like into like it's just like Bootstrap is not a lot. I really would not call it a lot, but it gave me the confidence to at least look at mobile friendly design. And now that I have it and I understand it a little bit, it's making it very quick to break down the page the way I want it to. So I appreciate it for that. Oh, good. Oh, do you use Bootstrap? It makes it easy. I'm glad that I learned it. I'm glad that I started learning. 12. And then we'll do div class equals call. -6. Call-xs-12. Yeah, what other frameworks do you use? God, the streamers know how to use the Twitch emotes. Like, I found it like very like when I first started streaming. I'm still pretty new, but I really couldn't figure out the emotes. Like, it was hard for me to like understand. Like, I knew Kappa, I knew Feels Good Man, I knew Feel Bad Man, but like there's a lot which I don't understand. Like that one I don't understand, WD. It's going over my head. Officially over my head. Why? I'm like having the hardest time like managing. It's because I haven't streamed in like a week. That's an issue. Yeah, I don't know what debated is. I Urban Dictionaryed that word the other day. I didn't know that it was like a Twitch emote. Feels Good Man is my favorite. Okay. So we don't have any content here, so yeah. We're gonna call this div article. Low energy, Patty. That's cool. That's good. So I'm glad that you've been like recovering and like I'm glad that it's like. At least it's relaxing. like as long as you can keep streaming, then I think that's got to be the most important thing. Whether it's if you're low energy and you're not feeling good about it, that's bad. But if you're low energy and you're like, okay, it's just chill, like that's fine. That's fine too. Like I had the balls to start eating on stream today. I don't like that. It was because I made a mistake and actually left my food on the stove, which was an unfortunate thing, but you know, yeah. Laravel and Bootstrap are my main frameworks. I still gotta look up Laravel. I plan to do a lot of PHP. I'd like to implement JavaScript too. So I don't know. It's hard for me with a very small view at both of them to understand which one is going to be better to implement, but we'll see. So this one, I just want to give a little bit of content. So hi. Whoa. I just accidentally coded some, what the heck is it called? Ooh, I've gone real careless today. I don't even have my notes out. That was called Emmet. I accidentally wrote Emmet. Link. And video. And you said you use PHP Storm as well, right? So you got like all the quick code stuff. Oh, so view details. I gotta link that up. So that is projects.php, save, workout bar, classic image responsive, and view details. So this is projects/. Okay, so we'll just copy and paste these. Dude, were you the one who told me about Emmet? Because it is very nice. It's a very helpful HTML tip, James. It's beautiful. It's beautiful how quickly you can write the structure of your code. And I didn't even use it, and that's because I haven't programmed in a couple, almost, I mean, 3 days feels like a really long time to not program. I don't know why. Is 3 days a lot of time to go without programming? Like, I don't know. Feels like a lot. Anyways, tripod.php. Right, so I have them linked. Okay, so I need to obviously okay, I can use Control F. Yeah. Yeah, I know I can use Control F. Was I looking for something? I think I'm okay. I do know I can use Control F. But like sometimes it's easier to just scroll to it. So if you see me doing that, don't get mad at me. Include, oh, okay. Unfortunately, I gotta write a new. This will give me. I really hate how I named these, but it's such a bear to like go through everything. I mean, it's going to take me 5 minutes, but yeah. Yeah, I understand. I like tips. I do, WD. You can stay around here and give me all the tips you want. I need them. Okay, WD, it was great having you in the stream, man. I appreciate it very much. Let's see. How do I want to do this? Because... Okay, that's whatever. It's just a name. It'll do the same thing whether it's not named Project Nav 1. I'll call it a project. I'll need two of these because I'm going to have two levels. Oh, yes. Thank you. Thank you for being nice to one of our community members, Patty. Always got to support each other in here. Except for, I've had to ban guys that came into this. Patty, have you ever had to ban people? Like, there's guys that come in and they just, like, start, like, literally, like, they're going insane. They're just, like, talking about, like, literally, like, fake stories that they come up with in their head. And it's just, like, I've had to ban people. And I thought I wouldn't have to do that. But I did. Okay, we're gonna import. This is what we need in Project Nav 1. Yeah, like the crazy one. Sometimes I try to go along with it, but then like I realize I'm trying to work right now, and then these people are like making me like read chat all day long to talk crazy with them, and it's. Yeah, exactly. I try to go along with them. But like sometimes they just get weirder. And it's tough. It's a tough call. So I'm gonna have to just this is fine back. So yes. Projects have one. Oh really? Do you have an interesting story? Like you've streamed longer than me and you've streamed more than me. Have you had any interesting stories that you can tell? I'd love to hear if you've had any interesting like people come in and like ask you to like work on projects, like, hey, you're good at this game, how would you like to play professionally? I wonder if you've had any of those encounters. I changed. Oops. Okay. Footer is broken. Footer level. That is an issue. Build to open. Okay, so I think this should fix it. Video link high. Need to make these. Oh my god. Dude, that's so funny. I like people want to make money off of Twitch streamers, so like you'll see that, I'm sure. It's like no one's asked me if I want anything designed for them. I guess I haven't been like around long enough. I'm sure I'll get it, but like a guy one time while I was doing 3D animation, and a guy came in and he asked me to do a logo for him. He wanted me to do a logo, and he wanted me to do like Twitch alert, like animations for him. And I was like, that sounds great. I would love to do this for you. And I was like, what do you want? And he sent me an image. And then I was like, okay, I have an idea about this. What do you think about it? And I never got a response. I told him the idea, and then the guy just, I never heard from him again. And I was like, I don't know. Some people like aren't, I don't like, that's just a person that like isn't gonna be very successful on Twitch. He's not ready to stream yet. He's trying to communicate with somebody as professional, and it just doesn't, like, he just never even got back to me. I didn't give him a quote or anything. Like, I was excited to like have potential to like get paid work, but it was, I would have been probably very difficult to work with him. He probably wouldn't have paid me. I probably would have sent him to him. But hello, Iowly, how are you, man? What's going on? Did I say your name right? Or would it be Aioli? main container. Like, give this. Do you know Patty Bay? Wait. Garlic spread? Is that the name of a garlic spread then? Need this one's gonna be a dot. Let's see. Or project promo. It sounds really good. I really don't. Yeah, I guess I love garlic. I love mayo. I love dips. Whoa, Dizzer, how are you doing, man? What's going on? Let's see. We gotta include our thingy and import project promo. I don't have anything in here yet. The code. And we will target that project promo container. Yeah, Dizzer, do you stream? Oh my god, guys, I forgot to tell you, and this is probably not a big deal, and Patty, you probably have already, oh my gosh, I gotta tune into you. Let me click your channel, I gotta give you a follow. Wow, you have more followers than me. Okay, well, forget about it, I need to tune into your stream. Let's see. What do you... Oh, learning Laravel. Oh, you do some gaming. Okay. That's exciting. I'd like to tune in. I'd like to see some of the variety that you bring. Very cool. It's great. Like, I really like the Twitch community because other streamers watch other streamers, and I mean, it's great. He's on my good list. That's fantastic. I'm sure Dizzer has some tricks up his sleeve. Oh, okay, he's new, right? Okay, he's new to Laravel. You should teach him. It's actually like, for the size, it's very like, it doesn't seem like it's very big, but it's very active, and I think like there's a lot of room for people to grow here. I like the animation section. Like I have a friend who streams like all the time, and he doesn't really gain any followers. He just streams animation, and he's a great streamer. Like he's one of my favorite streamers that I watch, and it's hard to get a following on the animation section. And there's not a whole lot of people on there. There's not a whole lot of streamers, not a whole lot of people interested. So I still like teaching people anything. I mean, look at my gameplay. Oh man. I've been playing, you know, a lot still, and I'm starting to feel like how important it is that other people provide build ideas for like items on your heroes, because it's so important. And I tried to create my own build and just sucked. Like it was so ineffective. I got like the lowest gold I've ever seen. Yeah. It was unfortunate. It's a difficult game, and I'm happy that there's so much give back from the community there. Streaming is real life. Yes. It's more real life than like sitting here and like not streaming. I gotta say that. But look, I've been sitting in this class for like how long? I don't know, maybe 4 minutes, 4 or 5 minutes. Let's get some CSS coded, shall we? I think this is actually set up. So let's go ahead and look up here. We've got section. I think what we're eventually gonna need to do div dot embed responsive. Div.embed responsive. God, I freaking love it. It's great. Using the Emmet is such a time saver. What'd you do to your keyboard? Okay, sounds really good. I thank you for lurking or commenting. You're fantastic here. I think it's amazing what happens to a streamer who has two viewers and then all of a sudden three, and then it just spikes. Like it's amazing. Like you get it's just cool. Like I don't know. Like you feel like as soon as that viewer count pops up one, you're like, I have chances. not that I keep count on my viewer count or anything like that. I don't care. Who cares about their viewer count? I would be fine streaming to zero people, as long as I can talk to myself. I think I do benefit from streaming. Oh, I thought you may have smashed a dessert. That would have been me. That would have been why I had to work on my keyboard. Like, oh, I gotta put in all my little mechanical keys again because I broke it or something. It's the truth. You can't go, like, I guess you can't, I was gonna say you can't lose followers, but you can lose followers. One day if I stop streaming forever, I go down. How did I do this on one of my other pages? On the index.php, I did an embed responsive. Control C. Hey, Eggtacular. How you doing, dude? What's going on? I love the name, by the way. Eggtacular. Is that like a reference to like you got egg tactics? Eggtacular. Do you know Eggtacular? I'm getting famous people in this chat here. This is fantastic. Everyone knows each other. Whoa, I got a follow. Eggtacular, thank you for the follow. I appreciate it. I don't know if I said anything to you, WD. I think I did. WD202, I got a follow from you 28 minutes. And thank you for the follow. I think I missed you. Spectacular. But you have a spectacular, but egg and spelt wrong. So not really spectacular. Is my reset password functionality finished? Yeah, it is finished. It's on my website, it is. On this current, I don't have any PHP written on this site currently, except for like some basic stuff to like do includes and stuff like that. But yeah, the forgot password function is working. You know, it sends an email and things like that. Wait, a token? What do you mean it needs a... Oh, you want like one like a something like this next to the login? You want a forgot password token? The question mark is a token in some way. Like I could do like a question mark forgot password thing. And that would kind of... Well, username and email and then responding to an email. You don't just like... No, I mean one email. Wait, how does this work? Token param. I figure like, yeah, okay. I mean, so tell me more, because I wasn't worried about this function, because my thinking is, okay, my website is not very popular. I'm not really worried about, additionally to not being popular, if someone's account gets hacked, they're not losing a lot of personal information. They're not losing a lot of, you know, personal, there's no finances on here that people can take. No one can see any of their own, you know, credit card information or anything. It's all done through PayPal. Well, you would have to answer, you'd have to have your email set up. Like, the way it works, let's see, forgot password. So I go, I don't even know if this is the email address associated with this account. So then it sends a blank page, but still one. And then I get an email. Whoa, you made an account? Wow. Whoa, he's signed up for the website. I thought I was getting an email from my forgot password thing. You're one of the first people on the stream that has made an account at the website. I think that's really cool. Okay, I'm gonna go back. I think that this will come to my email. It takes a couple minutes, unfortunately. Let's open up my chat again. Hold on. I know. Hmm. Oh, so you, if you, if I maybe included a random number in the and created an ID for the request. Okay, that's a good check actually. I didn't. Okay, how did I? Yeah. I need to get my email. Oh, there we go. Yeah, that sucks. I'm actually upset at myself for doing that. I, for some reason, like, I didn't think it was as bad as it was. I thought that, like, the case was, I figured the case was, yes, the email is, I know that the URL would come back as that, but I figured that no one else would guess that. Like, and that's so simple. Like, I suck at programming. I could still reverse engineer that. Thank you. Thank you very much, Egg. I appreciate that. I gotta do that before anyone hacks me. Please. You know, please don't do it. Nice me. Oh, hello, Mr. Demon Wolf. I'm so sorry. I was figuring out a problem. A guy just told me that I can be hacked, essentially. And I gave the entire stream of eight people information to hack me. Yeah, absolutely. I gotta take a note about that because that's awful. I did it a while ago, and I'm wondering if I knew that there was an issue. I don't even think I did. I think I really just thought like, oh well, it's fine because but as soon as someone hits does tries to use a forgot password form, they know the mechanism if they know PHP, and then they immediately have it. Time to open Kali Linux. What is that, Mr. Demon Wolf? So I currently can be hacked. Okay. I know, Eggtacular, you're right. That's just Cyan, thank you. Hey, how are you doing? Thanks for being here. Thanks for saying hi. How are you doing today, Mr. Cyan Wolf? Do you implement a sample with SASS? What do you mean? A sample? Oh, can't. Do you want a sample? Do you want me to show you how SASS works? I'd love to show if anyone doesn't know how it works. That's really what I'm doing here. Even though I spend like 90% of my stream talking to chat and 10% working, I am here to write SESS code and teach people. So if anyone would like to know about what I'm doing, if you're not sure, please let me know. I'd be glad to talk about it. So I gotta give this a class. So we're gonna take bad responsive. Yes. So that's so funny. I can't believe I did that. You can reset anyone's email. So no one. Oh my gosh. Someone noticed. I do not have Windows active because I bought this a PC from CyberPower PC, a great computer company, and that came with a Windows disk with an expiration with a code. I was able to use Windows, so I never decided to activate it. And then when I was throwing away junk, I accidentally threw away my disk. So now I don't have my installation CD and I don't have my activation key. So no one don't tell anybody. Where do I work? I work from home. I'm at home. I'm taking a year off from school right now. I'm taking classes over the summer, and then I'm going back to school to finish off my degree. But right now I'm pursuing this little business idea here that I have. I've ended up just becoming like a web developer because that's all I've been doing recently. But yeah, no, it's unfortunate. I don't really care though. I should like hide that or something. Oh, good, Dizzer. I'm very, very happy. I'm very happy for you. Yeah, my keyboards are no like my keyboards get like disgustingly dirty. It's unfortunate, and I've gotten this mechanical keyboard which doesn't have like any inset buttons, so I can very easily clean it now, and it's great. Mr. Demon Wolf, how do you? I can hide it on stream, Mr. Demon Wolf. So that's what I'm thinking. How do you get? How do people do that? Like, is there like a Pirate Bay Windows download or something like that? Paid here. The idea of potentially not updating Windows scare me. Oh, jeez. I technically paid for it, probably. I mean, the company that I purchased the PC from, they probably included that price somewhere in the price of the computer. So, whether they have a deal or not. Oh, legit keys. Cool. Let me see. Source equals, this is going to be, I'm going to go to my YouTube channel. I have a viewer on YouTube, but I think it's just me. Wow. Videos. Go to this. Need to take this guy. I think a home version. Yeah, I do have a copyright issue. On this one is. I have some copyright issues. Like I use songs like I'm doing now, you know, that I download from YouTube like a dickhead. And then I upload YouTube videos. I don't know. It's unfortunate. But I've since then like started incorporating my own stuff. And also music that is from like my video editor, and so I'm steering clear from that much more actively. Why do I not use no copyright music? I think like I come up with ideas like for my own music choice that I think is gonna work with the vibe that I want to bring, and it's like I feel like that point of view wouldn't come very easily if I just randomly search for no copyright music. I'm now looking, I'm using my own stuff now. I'm using like stuff that I own now from purchasing Camtasia, the video editing software I use. Dude, I love hardstyle. You freaking love hardstyle? It's my favorite. I have been, like, my mind and my body and my soul have been just completely overtaken by hardstyle over the last year. It's so, yeah, I love Camtasia. I've gotten pretty quick with it. There's definitely like a speed curve. Like, you can start getting very fast at it, and I think that's the most important part. I like being able to pump out videos. Their recent update fixed so many issues that I had with the software before I did that. So I've been very happy with Camtasia. I'd love to hear some more hardstyle. I tend to stay away from like raw. I don't really love raw hardstyle. I don't like I want to show you a song that I found recently. Venom hardstyle. This song. What is this? Jason Payne. Like this song. I don't really like this song. It is like people talk about like hardstyle not having skill, and this guy just made this like ridiculous kick, and then he's got like this atmosphere to this song, I guess, that people are happy with, but listen to the freaking, I want everyone's ears to just like feel this music. I'm not a huge fan of the raw style, but okay, let's play your playlist. This actually isn't that bad. I've heard worse. I for some reason wasn't like super. I wasn't like super like turned off by that song, but it's okay. What do we got here? Ooh. Okay, so there's some Zatox. I'm excited for this. I've heard a lot of these actually. I know Don't Care, I know Starting Over. I don't feel like 100% sure that I know that. This is gonna be some new music for me. I appreciate this. Let's see. What specs do I have in my PC? I will show you the system information. I don't even know if this is like information I shouldn't show. It is fine. I know that. It's AMD FX 4300 quad core processor, 3800 megahertz, 2 cores. 8 gigs RAM. Stuff like that. I should not show my product ID. Which, I mean, honestly, I'm not like that worried. Oh no! Not my time zone! Uh-oh, no one look. I need to hide it. I don't know. I'm fairly sure my, like, this website, thedoityourselfresource.com, was DDoS while I was streaming as, like, one of my first times. But I'm not paranoid about that happening, and as well, it wasn't a big deal. But I spent, like, 15 minutes, like, just trying to ban all of the IP addresses that were shooting information at my website. I eventually like may have stopped it. I did as best as I could to stop it, but I'm like programming so slowly right now. Okay, let's get going. Dude, don't show that on stream, dude. I just got your PM. Yeah, I'm not sure what CSRF is. Huh. Yeah. Okay, you got lower processor speed, but more RAM. Really? 100%. I mean, I know, like, there's, like, popular websites that get DDoSed. Do they just not have that? Also... Huh. Right, but I showed my product ID. I don't think it was there. I don't know. I don't know if I showed my pro. I don't know if I showed it, but I need to fix my image. This song is nice. I'm really liking this song. This is a good share. And I want to reduce the size of this video. Okay, that's good. Looking at changes your email as you're signing in. Alright, let me... How do I inspect so I can look in... Look at the code of that. How do I look at the code, Egg? I don't know how to inspect the code. Oh, I mean, I don't know. Maybe I should know. I don't know. Yeah, I checked your PC. You got the slower processor but better RAM than I do. God, my PC was like $450 and I was super happy with that. That's pretty damn good for a laptop. I would like that. Okay, click it and then inspect. Wait. I don't like to just click things. I need to know what this does. Whatever. I believe you. Okay, so it's error equals needs logging when I click that button. I don't know if that's what you expected to happen. Or maybe I was supposed to go, oh, inspect. Oh. Post email address. Huh. Wow, so are you, you're literally, you're giving, I don't know exactly, you're giving my website information when you click that button. This is the URL. Wow. That's crazy. Yeah, you're right. That's insane, actually. I've never heard about that before. I mean, I got my so-called education from... I got my so-called education from basically YouTube videos, and I made sure I watched a multiple talking about doing login systems, and none of these ever highlighted that. A token would also work upon changing your give, or maybe you have a unique token every time you log in, and you're checking to make sure that login request has the same token. You're giving a token additionally. Wow, that's freaking crazy. Yeah, I never thought about that. Like, it makes sense. Like, I understand PHP enough to know that that post request would interact with my website. So that's interesting. Like, thankfully still, like, I have admin control, you know, and not enough of a loss to really be worried about those sort of things, but it's kind of, it could be very annoying. Thank God at least I knew enough to, like, prevent my database from being stolen, and I hash passwords and things like that. So that's great. Yeah. No, I appreciate that. I've never had anyone test my website. Like, with how do you know this stuff? Like, that's incredible. I didn't know about that. CSRF. Yeah, very good knowledge. Fix this website. Oh my gosh, you do? So, okay, well, that perspective, you gotta make YouTube videos. People are over and over again creating these websites from these YouTubers who think that they know what they're doing. And, wow. That's really interesting. So, like, that's crazy that you get the hack for money. You get to, like, hack people's stuff and get paid. You get to learn hacking and get paid for it. I mean, I don't know. I mean, most people would see that and say, okay, well, you're just setting yourself up for life there. Okay, so that's freaking cool. We're going to... I do have some styling to do there, but I know that this is... too big. So XS-3. This is gonna be. Yeah. Like there's this very, it's very basic stuff to do, like password hashing, and then like, you know, checking database entries for like, you know, malicious characters and things like that. But I think that those things are obvious enough that they should be included, and it's surprising that someone with the level of knowledge that, you know, this YouTuber is trying to teach people, you know, doesn't have. I think that's interesting. Is CSRF is free, right? I don't know. We'll see. I have. Is this CSRF? McAfee Secure. Certified Secure. Do I have, is this it? Is this what I have? I mean, I have an SSL. I thought that this would be like, I don't even know what this does. Like, is this like, yeah, we bought something. Like, is that all that's saying? Do you have any idea what that is? Why am I having... Yeah. Mm-hmm. What do you mean, snake oil? That doesn't sound like a compliment. I'm happy to have that verification for people, but you know, like I just want to try not to turn people away on a first impression, especially as a new website. That was why I invested in that. And I thought, and like I was convinced that it would help with SEO, and I still get no page views on the website, so that's okay. We're gonna give this a class, probably. Albeit false, right? I want them to know. I don't even know what HTTPS does. Like, why? What's the purpose? I was happy to finally be able to put it in my browser. I mean, like all the big websites have it. And it's also cool because I've learned a lot on Twitch. I've been very happy with like the amount of feedback that I've gotten from this community. It's really cool. Encrypts the request. So where am I vulnerable without HTTPS? Like I what is it? What does it do? Like, you have HTTP on your site. If you're using my Wi-Fi network, this victim can log into your account. Credentials are sent over HTTP in clear text. Oh, wow. MIT. You're like, by the way, like, you are probably the most important person that could ever be in any sort of web development stream. When the web developer, I mean, anyone, like, I don't think that, like, you're trained in this stuff. And I mean, I can't imagine that all web developers automatically have this knowledge from school or whatever. I'm sure that they're taught, hey, it's important, but do they actually have courses on web, you know, web protection? I mean, I remember my uncle got a master's in computer science, and he was talking a lot about having encryption courses and things like that, and cybersecurity. But I don't know. I don't know what the curriculum's like. Maybe I'm right. I don't know. And this is Project Promo. Project Promo link. Okay. So it's really for like on the network stuff. I mean, would you ever be able to just look at a website's HTTP requests, like, in general? Like, would you ever be able to go to someone's website and just see what's going on? I would guess no, but I mean, there's got to be a way, like, there's got to be a way. I don't. Huh. Promo link. So, from your line of work, like, you really have to understand, like, are you actively looking at ways to break into systems, like new ways? Like, are you always trying to look at the basics and understand the vulnerabilities? Like, so do you have a very good understanding of like the basics of how things work on the web in order to be successful at your job? Huh. There's more power than I know. I mean, I'm doing things very on a very basic level. I wouldn't even know how to give myself a bad HTTP request. Wow. Like, huh. I don't even, like, I would love to ask more questions. Like what is another big thing that you see? Like, that people are getting, like, what is, like, one of the most common ways that websites are getting hacked? It's not, like, obvious. Like, I know about, like, the database, you know, God. SQL injection. I know SQL injection. Like, what's one that, like, you know, like, isn't, like one of the ones that are, like, you know, very upfront taught? So this one is, we'll talk about the A, and we'll give it color. Let me style project promo. IDOR, and insecure direct object references. Okay. So yes, account ID. I'm hearing you. Huh. I have. Isn't that like. Okay, is that where you're like. You're looking at like HTML and you're changing like HTML, like account IDs and things like that? Or is that like. I remember looking at like some tutorial which talked about. The fact that you could look at like HTML and figure out crucial information about your account or figure out like names of variables and things like that and you maybe would know like I've heard people like say not changing source. Okay, this is probably over my head. I have a background color on this page. I have one. Or two. Two. Intercepting on her. Am I opening the image? Okay. Let's see. There's tools to do that. For example, intercepting a request on your site using Burp Suite proxy. User agent. So this is on your request to the browser. No cookies. So, okay. Yeah, I would like to, like, what would a more detailed report look like, and what sort of information would you be getting? So this gets information from your browser? And is this looking at, like, all this stuff is obviously non-threatening, maybe the IP? I don't know. Your post request. Yeah. Okay. Wow. So you submit the form on your browser, your proxy catches it, and then you're getting that information. And then what are you forwarding? Is this my styling? Oh, there we go. Now the text is white. So the background color is not set. Okay. Yeah, I'd love to see an example. Would, but so on, is the request stalled by your proxy? Is that like an appropriate statement? Like, is the request stopped? So are you basically having your proxy, like, it's taking the request, and then from there you can do stuff with it, like by the proxy? I guess I'm not sure. Like, I know, like, I remember the only my only like look at a proxy was basically like when my school used to ban like certain websites and things like that. Like, we couldn't get on YouTube. So you're looking at that request, and the proxy is obviously taking it away, so you can't get to it. Is that so? That's like a similar thing, and you can actually get information from that. Wow. That's pretty interesting. So you could edit it to one, and then you could like, so would that be pop would that be possible to do on my website? Well, I check if you are logged in. So I mean, like, is that like is am I in danger? Like, I have a few checks. Like, I check if that account ID is logged in. And like, that's crazy. And like, to find that, like, do you have like software that can check all these things for you, or like, is this or like, do you have or are you just like brute force testing? Like, it'd be cool to like develop a software that could find vulnerabilities in the site. Like, hey, for example, like your site is giving here. Do you have like, you could then give that user of the software information that says like, well, to resolve this security issue, you can do this. I feel like that should be there. I feel like that should be a thing. I mean, I guess. Like, you'd have to test it would have to work, right? Wow. Right. Yep, you always got to confirm it. What do you think is like, what's the most scariest hack you've ever seen? Like, is there anything that surprises you anymore? Like, I almost imagine like hackers know basically magic tricks, and like there's these like secret, like very like subtle vulnerabilities in systems that can be exploited. Like, so that like very that very kind of mysterious ability to hack is what I imagine. Like, is it more like, is it more easy to spot than you would expect? Seen it all. Oh my gosh. Is there anything that like you would admit like would get you? Like, do you imagine like there's like some hack that would get you? Like, or do you like, I don't know. Papa says, Foot's 92. How are you doing, Foot? How's it going? I've been streaming for probably, I've been streaming for 2 hours and I've coded probably three lines or something like that. This is a very productive day. Why are we not giving? I'm just like trying this, forget this to like load its background. What am I doing? I'm coding up this page in CSS, trying to get this worked out, but I can't even get my background color on it. Like I've discovered vulnerabilities in my site thanks to, well, Eggtacular has discovered vulnerabilities in my site, which I don't feel good announcing, but I still have them, and I only have like zero legitimate users, so I guess it's an okay thing to talk about. We're kind of in a working, you know, development state, you know, by definition is what we're developing the website right now, so I guess I'm okay with that, but it's rough. Did I write? Huh. Background overwrites background color. So I have background. I think it just didn't load. So I have a background. Where did I do a background? I don't even. Scroll down to the debugger. This debugger? Yeah, I would guess so. I mean, I'd imagine like you on a big project, like they start out building Facebook.com and they try to, you know, implement a new system, and then they get the right people to do the job, and then you have a good website built from ground up. But I'm sure Facebook has been hacked, I'm sure, right? Oh, I didn't know this was called the debugger. Check main container div. So, display block, margin top.
Home main container will have a background color. The body tag. Wow. So it was there. Getting a lot of very strange noises that I'm hearing, like they seem like subconscious, but I know that. Oh, okay. It's not a big deal. It's just neighbors, but it, like when the kid was like coughing and it was like disgusting sound, and I thought like my dog was dying or something. Wait, they pay a lot for, oh wow, 40k a couple months ago for finding RCE. Whoa, Facebook. I want to believe that all of you know about image magic and it's tragic. This issue is found in the end of the April 2016, and due to many processing plugins, depends on Image Magic Library, which has a huge impact. There were evidences that other information about this issue was available, not only for researchers who discovered it, also for others. I was testing some big service, not Facebook, when some redirect followed me on Facebook. It was a share on Facebook dialogue. This guy's English is pretty bad, but I'm getting the gist of it. Many of you can see, if we look closer, we can see that a picture parameter is a URL, but there isn't image URL on the page content like mentioned above. google.com/error/robot.png becomes that. First of all, I thought about some kind of SSRF issue. So that was what you were talking about. No. What did I... IDR, never mind. SSRF. So I'm not sure what SSRF is. You're Russian English. Yeah. CSRF and IDR. Those are the, I know the difference between the acronyms now, but it was hard. First of all, I thought it was. Okay, but tests showed that URL from this parameter requested from 31.13.97.star network by Facebook kernel. This is the proxy connection he was looking at it. Yeah. Server side request forgery. Huh. How would you do a server-side request forgery? Huh. Remote. Proper request from isolated server. Inky's application burns image with some further. Dig deeper. After some test of this parameter, parse SVG. Oh wow. I've heard about this. There's information stored in these images. You get an SSRF issue. Not always. Oh, is this one? No one's fired. Image trick is last. Image tragic is last hope. Okay, off the company block, common request but not DM. Quarter under attack control bonus trigger. Is of this, it said that. Oh, what the heck? I don't know anything about how to store information inside of SVGs, but that's interesting. Remote codecs. Running code on a victim server. Oh god. The application workflow, get the picture parameter and request it. This request is correct and not vulnerable. Receive picture passes on converter's instance.
which means vulnerable image magic library. Trying to find some common way to exploit this HTTP request, short test shown that either all outbound ports are closed or I will spend a lot of time trying to find one that would be open. So what do they get? Is this guy a blog, what is this guy? Okay. This is a favorited website. This is freaking cool. He only has two. I could. No, it's not a subscribe button. Wow. Pretty cool. Very technical security vault. I don't understand. I wanted to say I don't understand the English, but that's not what I don't understand. I don't understand any of his technical talk. I don't know. I don't know any acronyms. I can't read any of his code. I don't know what a payload is. I don't know what a shell application is. I don't know what a... This is some stuff right here. Whoa. Got a follower and I missed it. Terrible. Matrix, if you're still here, I appreciate your follow. You're awesome. I thank you very much. Yeah. I'm sure it would have been a little bit easier if he had good English. But let's see. I want to fix my website. I'm going to fix this. I'm going to try to bring the Z index of this up. I think one of my issues is that this div I think it's because of Bootstrap, honestly, but I don't really have a fantastic idea of why Bootstrap makes this not work. So I'm gonna call this I think I need to embed Bootstrap. You know what? I can actually add this class name to here, and that's what I want to do. I've not done this a few times now. I think it's a mistake. Do you have any more blogs like that? I think that's a really interesting perspective, and I think if this guy is posting new information like that, that'd be very cool. Free money on a Bitcoin site? I'm gonna go back to it. I'm gonna go back to this guy. How did you find this? Is this like a popular article?
every time I test money related systems, I am very interested not only in common issues from injection, XSS, IDOR. This is probably a good link. So on, but also from business logic issues and issues math. Here's a short list that have been found in some application. Race condition, transfer from RUB account to USD account with one-to-one exchange rate, ground issues, and many others. And it is one case to talk about something in theory. Tension. Race condition in theory might lead to days transfer limit bypass. Okay, this doesn't make sense to me. Days transfer limit bypass. Cool, but it isn't interesting at all. Next to the other case, when it explains step by step what, how, and why follows one another and show the result. I'll show you a real example. Hello hackers, we are reaching out to everyone that has worked on the iBit exchange to notify you of some changes in our bug bounty program. The increased payouts for vulnerabilities submitted to our platform. Are you freelance at all on this stuff? Like, does this... That's pretty... Okay, I'm going to look at the OWASP top 10 for sure. Like, do you do any stuff like this? Like, freelance bug fixing? Like, this sounds interesting. $100,000 to $200,000. If you have not tested the exchange in a while, we would welcome you back. You're hunting for new bugs. Well done. That's super cool. Are there companies out there like dedicated to hiring developers to find bugs like in an organized way, or like is it all freelance? 14,000 dollars from Yahoo for a single issue. Another. Oh my gosh! All right, well, I'm gonna read this guy. I got too many things to bookmark. Okay. HackerOne. Are they scary? Are they competition for you? How do you advertise yourself? How do you market your services? Provides users as many wallets as you want. Are on the platform. Three requirements. Hacker has two accounts. At least one of them is funded. Threat balances are... This is the same program you use. Hey Josh, how are you? What's going on, man? You sign up and hack companies? That's so fun! Dude, that's crazy. Alright, I wanna pursue this. I wanna pursue this as a career. Oh good, Josh, I'm glad to hear that, man. We're hearing about I got my website hacked. In a good way, and then now I'm looking at some hacking stories from people that professionally hack websites. So this is quite the learning experience today. We're not really doing front end anymore. I mean, I'm doing it occasionally, but not a whole lot. Oh geez, so you guys get along. You guys can get along, maybe. He seems like he's legitimately a good guy though. I think I could trust Egg. It sounds cool. Like I think the things that you're dealing with are some of the really basic stuff, and I'm sure it feels good to like be able to, you know, like make somebody feel like they have more control over their service, because the internet's obviously, judging by the need for you guys on top sites, there's a lot of stuff that is not fully understood, and that's crazy. Five figures a month. Oh my gosh. Patty, thank you so much for alert. I appreciate you staying in here. I hope your Call of Duty went well, or CSGO went well. Yeah, have a great day, dude. Yeah, absolutely. God, I'm in here in Twitch getting friggin' free advice. I feel like a jerk because, like, I've learned more about programming web development from Twitch than I probably have on YouTube. I mean, it's good stuff. You guys are like professional debuggers. Like that guy who was in here before, I don't know if he's still there, but comes in, he looks at my screen and he's like, I know exactly what CSS error you made. And I mean, that's amazing. Like super helpful. So, okay, let's look at this. So this is the HD, this looks like IDOR, right? They have a token. Name, wallet, available. Usually he's getting all this information. And this is this JSON or? Yeah, it is great. And he does it, and it's great when you can be like friendly and help people too. Like some people like, I don't know, like there's a lot of complaints here like, oh, it's just a guy helping, a guy always coming in telling you what to do. And if you're really being kind of rude about it, like then it's unfortunate. But like I've been so open to help, and I think it's been great to receive it, and it's awesome. An issue with the onboarding flow in the beta environment resolved in the middle of October. Ready and fake funded. Transfer 0.001 from account. What? Okay, so he did this. He actually transferred that amount. .005 less. Whoa. That's crazy. Source account balance does not change, but the target account does. So you're... They took a part of it? Yeah, they are the minority. The people I've had to like dismiss from the stream are people that are like crazy and like... Like I've had people like going on like 45 lines of text, this like insane story that is like probably could not even have been thought of in a dream, and this guy's like just going on like he's on some sort of drugs, or just trolling me, and I can't think about anything but what he's telling me. So Oh no. I actually don't know the answer to that question, John. 26 sounds right. I don't think that there's an odd number. When I was little, I remember, like, I transferred schools, and in my school, we hadn't started algebra, and in this school, they did start it. And I remember, like, I thought that algebra meant you, instead of thinking about letters as letters, you counted which position they are in the alphabet, and then you multiplied like 12 12B, B is the second letter in the alphabet. So 12B meant 24. And so I thought I was gonna have to just start doing math with like with letters meaning numbers. And yeah, I quickly realized that was not how it worked. Yeah, come into my Twitch chat and you figure out, you can ask questions to our community of how many letters there are in the alphabet and we will tell you. It will be known to you. So it's a true transfer. As a result, attacker produces 0.001 XBT for free. Moreover, there is no restriction or under transaction, such as number per day, one-time password, and so on. I just hope that they had some fraud control and that this vector will fall on withdrawal stage for the end. No, while fix was in progress, I found out that there is a business logic issue additionally to math's bug. There is no restriction to transfer from account one to account one or self-transfer. You're 37? Wow. I'm 23. I just filled out a form yesterday. I wrote down that I was 22. So I'm already freaking losing track. It's great you can find people of like different ages here. I mean, most of the guys are like 20, but I occasionally get like an older person. Wait, what? Oh, right. No, I would have thought. Okay. Well, you would. I think that I was thinking that like you replaced G with 7, and so it was just 37. G equals 7. So like, I thought, and as opposed to 3 times G. So I'm gonna write it out. I didn't think 3 times sheet. I know it. I did like the multiplication example, and then I didn't do it for some reason. Yeah. But I I know. I didn't make a whole lot of sense for me to all of a sudden do like substitutions. Do you like learn techniques from these guys at all? Wow, I got into some EDM crap right here. Maybe not crap, it's fine, but I was much happier with my hard style mix. Back. Application gets 0.005. Round it down to 0.00 and back from source balance. Balance does not change. Does not check that source and target balances are the same. Round up amount to 0.001 and add to target balance. Okay, so he just found this thing like falsely adding and also like incorrectly adding, like doing weird rounding and things like that, and not following rules that were supposed to be set. Oh man, I've got a barking dog downstairs. I don't know what. Let me go and tell my dog to be quiet real quick. Like we have neighbors and stuff. Not cool. Hey Spitty, how are you doing? We're gonna be right back. Just a second. Hey guys, sorry about the delay at coming back like immediately. I got food. I'm sorry. So yeah, we have some interesting code in the chat here. I don't know Python at all, but it would be cool to it's something I want to learn. I don't really have a necessity for it yet. It's a language that is used to write custom add-ons to the program I used to do 3D animation called Blender. And so I'd be interested in learning it for you know, being able to use it to modify Blender, but I don't have any current use for it right now. Okay. So I figured out access forbidden. Huh. Wait, how? What are you doing this for? Can you explain to me what you're doing? How would you crack a password? Like, that sounds freaking intense. Let me figure out why this. Okay, these links are working now. Well, how does that work when you have form information, you know, form stuff? How does that work when you have a form which gives you only a certain number of attempts? Okay. Aww, you're gonna beat these guys. I'd like to figure out what is this game that you're playing? This game sounds cool. What's this game? You're gonna take out game. Don't take out Deep World. Is it an app? Wow. Are you sure they don't have any login, you know, like security breaches? Like I know if I fail a couple login attempts on like RuneScape, for example, I can't continue to try to log in. Played 1600 hours. Wow. That's more hours than I played on Dota, which has been essentially like logged in like the last year, so maybe it's not that much. I played probably a lot more. I probably put a lot more hours than that into like RuneScape, which game I would say that I main for, you know, quite a few years. Okay, I gotta code my CSS, unfortunately. So if I go to like premium, like this one. Now all these pages
I need to give some sort of margin on this video. Used to make websites and they got really boring. It's not like the most intense thing I've ever done in my life. I really like doing new things, but like, I don't like front end very much. I would like a mixture, but it gets like working for like a couple weeks straight on front end is sort of like uninspiring, I'd say. You don't have a lot of like these problems that just like, you know, take over your brain and like make you think about it all the time. Like there's a lot of stuff that just needs to get done. I know, especially now, because I'm essentially copying and pasting styling. Wow, just tried to log in 20 times. I hope that you can at least get a good exercise out of this. I don't know how long it will take to actually crack a password with that method, but you know, I wish you good luck. So this is project promo. Iframe. I don't need to style the iframe. I actually really only need to style this, so margin. How much is this away from the top of this? Wow, I have a header up here that I can't even see. I literally can't even see that header. That's dumb. Oh no, it's here for like a second, and then it disappears. I see. They kind of did that. I wish I knew Python, I'd be interested in trying to generate your list with you, but it's probably more difficult than you'd expect if there's not already a class, like a library, like a class that would help you out with that directly. I know why. It's because I've done something that I normally don't do. You hate me or you love me. Don't ever f me. You hate me or you love me. We can make the scene turn up. You hate me or you love me. Trust me. You hate me or you love me. Oh, this excess as well. You hate me or you love me. Trust me. We can make the scene turn up. So instead of, I think that this might do what I want it to do.
Okay, so that, yeah, that did it. Okay, how, yeah, so if you're, what is your goal in your password cracking code? Do you just want to try as many combinations of letters and numbers as you can? Like, if you took at my password, for example, like, there'd probably be millions of things that you try before you did it. I applaud you for trying, but I don't think that, like, password hacking is something that's done on, like, a desktop computer. Like, if you really want to generate millions of combinations of letters and numbers, like, you're talking about, like, a lot of data. I don't know. You got letters, numbers, and potentially even, like, symbols. Like, and then uppercase letters, lowercase letters, every single, all numbers. There are a lot more combinations than that, though. Like, if you have you're saying there's only 260 combinations for a 10 letter password. That is actually more like, you've got A, you got 10 A's, you got a B and 9 A's, you've got a C and 9 A's, and then you've got a change in, you've got an A, 9 A's and a C, you've got 9 A's and a, like, there, that's an incredible amount of, an incredible number of, okay, 26 to the, oh my god. 26 to the 10. Oh my gosh. I wish you luck. I hope that you have a computer that can power through that. so
wasted.
I wanna actually take this, like, little animation I've got on this. Header H1. I need to define this drink in it. Huh. That sounds more reasonable than putting together all those numbers.
Restrained by your feelings. Flawless encounters.
To do the dictionary.
You just realize that it's all a big game.
I'm sure people have thought of, like, methods to do it, but it's also difficult because you're being encouraged to put numbers, symbols, things like that at the end of the password. So, as far as that goes, like, you wanna know what the restrictions are from the website that you're trying to break into. I mean, I don't have any requirement. So someone could just do some word between 5 and 12 characters, and then they can log into the site. So if that word was then breached, yeah, you'd have access to their account. But it's difficult. Like, these the brute force attacks like this are I don't think, like, exploited very often because it's too difficult. No, I'm opening a folder.
pleasure. Need to open up.
Restrained by your feelings. Flawless encounters. Time is running out.
New levels? Yeah. When I like I don't really feel ethically like good in helping you do it, but I can just tell you a story. When I used to play RuneScape when I was young, I was probably 13 years old, and I played this RuneScape private server, and it was a whole lot of fun, and I really, like, I mean, I enjoyed it, and then I played it for so much that I got to know, like, the owners, and then one of the owners decided to let me host the server on my computer, and so I hosted the server on my computer, and then this folder was created on my computer that had the usernames and passwords of every single person that was on the server. So I would basically go and I'd find the person that I wanted to hack, and I would ask them, what is your real RuneScape account name? And then so I'd look them up, and I loved trying to hack people when I was little. I used to ask people for passwords, like, in game and stuff. That was, but like, I asked the guy their real RuneScape account name, and then I'd go and I'd try the same password that they had on their private server, and it would work like 90% of the time. Almost everybody was using the same password for both accounts. So it was so bad. I mean, like, I could probably get banned on Twitch for doing that, but it was quite the experience. I'm looking for my so we'll open up. Web frames. So we'll drop this down. Okay, so shrink 8 seconds. It was bad. It was definitely bad game design. You know, like, it should be hashed. I had access to everything. And I'm sure that's not possible to do anymore, but I had I'm sure that, like, most private servers, that's not possible to do. But I had access to the entire private server source. I was like a bad kid there. That was interesting, because like this server had like maybe 20 players on it regularly, so it was reasonably popular. And I had a lot of power. It was pretty interesting. Header. Which one? Like this thing? So there's, yeah, I have some styling that I'm not gonna want. Like, margin top, margin bottom. I used to play Pirates of the Caribbean when I was a kid. I played it 10 hours a day on school nights, and then Disney made the genius move of closing it to help fund Club Penguin. Wait, Disney helped with Club Penguin? Are you serious? The heck?
I didn't know that of all, but they freaking ruined your game? That's not fair, man. I never played Pirates of the Caribbean. Oh, that's so rough. Oh, this needs... actually, this needs to be outside of this. Not fair, Club Penguin ruined. My mom spent so much money in Club Penguin. It was sad. My brother loved it. I was like, why would you ever? Why would you ever play freaking Club Penguin? Pirates Online. Not loading. But can I get to it from here? I can't load the website for some reason. Is it down? Let's see. So this needs to be out of this. That sucks. I don't know why I can't get on it. Let's try again. Maybe it's just loading really slowly. Time here. Oh, okay, we got it. The Legend of Pirates Online is a work in progress. We're a semi-open beta community server. We'll have much more to do. Huh. Have you played it yet? Hey Dizzer, what's going on, dude? How are you doing? Did you stream again? Thank you. I remember when I did you ever get to play Puzzle Pirates? I remember when Puzzle Pirates was a game. And I was always curious to play it, but like I could never download it for some reason. It was so annoying. And then instead of that, I chose to play Robot Rage or something like that. That was the best game I've ever played. And it's still like, if I could play that game, I'd be psyched. Aww. 100% free, that's awesome. That's really interesting. Oh, really? Don't you hate that when you try to lay down for a nap and it's just like, what is the point? Like, I can't do it.
Okay, so I've got my little animation here. I believe. Whoa. I'm gonna remove the Z index, text blind center, our color black. Seems that does this not need to be there anymore? It's like World of Warcraft but with pirates. That sounds cool. Okay, that fixed my. I think it may have been Z index, but I'm not sure. Sometimes people ask me what true love is. Join random.choice string.lowercase for x in that range. Everybody talks about, but only a few have ever seen. Friendship and affection are some of the greatest sources of happiness. Having that one in true love might be the biggest of. Interesting. And when you find it all in one individual, you should never let go. I could probably generate like some sort of array for you in like Mathematica and have it. I don't know. So let's go ahead and start styling up the rest of this. This page is taking us way too long today. Not getting a whole lot of work done. Alright, so this section here is really fine to like have it be its own section. Section class, project. Yeah, okay. I think my girlfriend just got home. We actually have to stop streaming for today. We're gonna be back tomorrow. I had a great time today. It's been a good. I think you guys can hear my dog barking. So, yeah, this is about time. It's been a great time. I will be back tomorrow, like I said just a second ago. And yeah, have a great night, guys. If you enjoyed the stream, leave a follow to catch us again next time. And other than that, enjoy yourselves. Good luck with your password cracker, Josh. I hope you can get at least a good exercise out of this, if nothing more. So, all right, man. Yeah, have a great night, guys. Bye.